In this video, you will learn about ArtText features that help with the logo design process. ArtText comes with a great variety of vector shapes and smart objects. You can use any of the 1500 supplied shapes to compose a logo or a badge, or use vector drawing tools to edit or create your own shapes. Let me show you how to quickly compose a cafe logo with shapes from the supplied collection. I will begin by adding a black background and dropping a wavy circle shape from the Badges category under the Shapes tab in the Source panel. In the Fill tab of the Inspector, I will choose a color or gradient fill for the shape. For my simple logo, a plain orange color will do. Then I drop another shape in the form of sunlight rays, also from the Badges category. But this time I will use a slightly lighter orange fill color. In the same manner, I will add and color spoon and fork vector shapes. Once I have my logo base ready, I will add a cupcake shape as the logo centerpiece. Double-clicking on a shape activates the built-in vector editor, where I will select and remove the cupcake cup and click Done. Then I fill it with a light red color. Now I will add another cupcake shape, but this time I will remove the top and fill the bottom with a dark red color. I can now group the two cupcake parts to work together as if it's a single object. Position it slightly above the center. When it comes to text for the logo, I will add two simple 2D texts via the plus button. Then I will change the top word to cupcake, and for the font, I will use a handwriting font from the Google Fonts collection. ArtText offers a convenient integration with Google Fonts. You simply need to expand the standard system fonts dialog. Now I will show you how to create your own vector shape for a logo using ArtText drawing tools. I will start by adding 9 contour points that will create a heart shape using the pen tool. Once I add the second contour point, I will slightly move the cursor to give the line a curvy shape. The same goes for every point I add. Then I will use the Move tool to change the heart shape curvature by moving the spline handles. Once the heart shape looks satisfactory, I click Done, and my newly created shape is ready for use. I can resize it and apply ArtText effects as with any other shape. To complete the logo design, I will type the word Love and leave a blank space in place of the letter O, which I will fill with the heart icon. What if ArtText has a shape similar to the one you need for a logo design? With minor tweaks, you can achieve the shape you need. So, I will now explain how you can quickly modify any of the supplied shapes. To start editing a shape, I will double-click on it to activate the shape editing mode. Moving and adding new contour points will let you modify shapes. I will extend the lower petal to create a stylized palm tree. Same as with the Love logo, I will type the word Mirage with a blank space in place of the letter I. In this space, I will place a flower shape from Flora. Now you're ready to create your new logo with ArtText.